Okay, I'm gonna make another video now. This one's gonna be about the Pathfinder tool. That's this one right here. And I try to avoid shape modes. And instead, what we're really gonna work with is true pathfinders. The difference to this is visually applied. This is actually truly applied. So let's just remake this. I don't know. Let's see, Pathfinder, we need to merge or subtract, so let's go with the arrow. So to get the arrow, I'm gonna hit the letter M, get a rectangle tool. Then I'm gonna go to Object, Path, Add Anchor Points. That gives me all these extras. I'll hit P for the pen tool. That allows me to move over a point and remove points. Okay, so that's good. Now I got the arrow part. Now I need the vertical stem of the arrow. Obviously they're a little off, so using the align tool would be a smart move. And then I want them as one shape. So that's where the Pathfinder tool would come in handy and merge. Now you remember, since Illustrator 7, that came out like in 2001, there's been an error in the Pathfinder merge tool. Unless these are default, white fill with the black stroke, sometimes they don't merge. So let's give it a shot and see. I'll try merge. No results, of course. But if I hit the letter D, it becomes white fill, black stroke. And then if I merge, oh, surprise, surprise, it does merge. And strangely enough, it drops the stroke. So now it's just become a white shape. And, you know, it disappears on white. And you're like, what the heck? But have no fear. If you just hit the letter I for the eyedropper tool, you can go over and you can get that. Okay, so there was the merge. You selected two objects and you chose this. Sometimes you had to select those two objects and hit D first and then merge. Now let me show you how to remove something. Use the head to remove this part to make the neck. So let me do that real quick. So I draw a rectangle. I draw a circle. I get them aligned. I get them spaced out correctly using the arrow keys right now. Now I want shoulders, so I'm going to round the corners. That's under Effects, Stylize. Round corners. I can see the amount and it's going to show me, I guess, say 6 pixels. Okay. And now that's visually applied, not truly applied. So I need to go Object, Expand Appearance. Now it's truly applied. Okay. Now I need a bigger circle from this circle to create the neck area. So I'm going to go Object, Path, Offset Path, and I'm gonna make it slightly bigger just so we can see it for sure. Okay, now I'm gonna use that path to remove a chunk from the torso. So with only those two selected, the head is not selected and other elements on the page aren't selected, I'm gonna go back to Pathfinder. This time I'll choose Divide. Divide works no matter what the colors. I don't know why it does. Now it's just a matter of deleting what I don't need. So obviously I don't need this. And yes, I don't need that. And there I have my little indication for the neckline, and there's the head, and there's that. Okay, so that shows you how to merge and also how to divide. So it also shows you rounded corners and offset path. So that's a little good review of where we're at last time. So I'll stop that video there. 1 second.